Today, I would like to talk a little bit about absent or remote healing and the experience of absent or remote healing. In many ways can be quite miraculous. People talk about miracle cures and phenomenal healing experiences beyond the norm. So although it's something we've always had in our capabilities from the beginning of time, it's not something that's necessarily got to a place of respect in the modern society, mainly because of the fact, of course, that conventional medicine and science holds the pinnacle of the success that's really given to the results in connection with modern healing and modern medicine, and rightfully so. But absent healing can sometimes have remarkable and indeed miraculous results. So quite often it's an ability that's underestimated, because as ever, when it comes to spiritual work, there's a simple side to it. There's a simplistic element to it that can be underestimated and create this feeling within the logical mind of, well, how could that possibly work? But of course, people that have experienced it really swear by it. And some people, of course, have had their lives absolutely changed by it, and therefore they proclaim it to be miraculous. So absent healing is done really through the transference of energy, or I think in an even stronger fashion, by the use of a spirit guide. I have a spirit Dr. Chan who works specifically with medical and health matters. And if I want to try to send some remote or absent healing to someone a distance away, then I will tune into his energy, tune into his vibration, think about the person that I wish to send the healing to and their energy and their vibration, and connect with them with my spirit guide, Dr. Chan. So effectively, he will visit them and be physically in the spiritual form on the higher vibrational levels, be literally with that person in the now, in the physical form. They might not see him, they might not even feel him, but it's often that people experience a temperature change. Often it feels that the temperature is rising, becoming warmer or even hotter in a region that's needing the healing, but it's not necessarily something you have to feel or experience when receiving absent healing. Sometimes you aren't aware of it at all because it's all carried out on a higher vibrational level. As the energy is taking place, as the healing is being given from the spirit guide to the recipient, it can be increased by the use of visualization from the person sending the healing or asking their spirit guide to give the healing. So personally, I like to work with my spirit guide at the same time. So I like to sort of be there with him whilst the healing's taking place. It's not always possible, of course, depending on time zones and so on, but that's generally the way I would like to do it. So I would sit in meditation and communicate with my spirit guides. I would try to get a diagnosis from my spirit guide, from Dr. Chan, and then ask him to carry out the healing for me, which would be mainly the transference of healing energy from the higher powers to the individual concerned. And afterwards, as ever, you know, he would return to the higher vibrations. I would close down my chakras, if you like, and energies, and switch off from the vibration, just as I would open up to it before I started, before communication, as is general practice. So absent healing can be phenomenal. Often it has to be repeated. It isn't always something that can work just in one go. Sometimes it needs recurrent activity, but the consequences can be phenomenal. And I can only speak from experience, from what people have told me from my past and what they've experienced. obviously everyone's different, everybody's capabilities are different, but from my experience with working with Spirit Dr. Chan, some of the results have been astounding. So good luck with your learning of meditation, astral travel, and absent healing, because they are all things that can be very, very valuable, particularly if you're wanting to help friends or family or people that you have a, you know, a strong connection with. You know, so it's invaluable, really, as an ancient art that's been virtually lost.